Witam Was serdecznie w piątym już odcinku z serii Wiedźmin 3 Serca z Kamienia. Jesteśmy w tym momencie już po skompletowaniu pełnej ekipy do napadu. A więc pojedźmy na miejsce, w którym mamy się stawić umówione wcześniej.
Supper I never refuse.
You'll choke to death on three.
Wow, got an early bird in our midst. Prime. Just one patrol. Mixture of yours must have worked. Eveline, you ready?
Are you kidding? Of course I am.
Three. Two, one.
It's clear. On your way.
Plowing city foul, shite all over again.
What? Not so.
Patrol's turning round.
We've 1 minute. Move.
Hail Mother today, hallowed mother, keep us from.
Serves. You assured us there'd be no one inside.
Seems my informer was wrong.
Is that all you've got to say? I nearly broke my neck.
You knew what you were signing up for. This is no time to argue.
Not the time, true. But we'll discuss this later. You can be sure of that.
At your service, mate. One guard could mean many more. You'd best draw your sword now.
No.
What now?
No one dies. Said so from the start.
whatever. Don your masks and let's go.
For now, knock on wood.
Good. Eyes in the back of your heads, everyone.
Mine are open. I've already seen several things I'd gladly take with me.
Not now. The vault. That's our...
Yes, but we shall raise the starting... Watch this! Guards! Guards!
Should have stayed in that cage.
You said...
I damn well know what I said. At them before they sound the alarm.
No ładnie, musimy walczyć z drewnianym mieczem.
Stop him! He's not to flee!
Lock themselves in.
Bollocks!
Damn it.
Lay down your arms! You have no chance!
Perhaps not.
But we do have hostages.
Mercy, Master!
On the count of three, we go in. One, two!
Come one step closer and folk will die!
Hold now!
We must negotiate.
What are your demands? To release the hostages?
Buy us a bit of time, Geralt.
We have one demand. Pull back from the auction house.
You know I cannot do that!
You can, just not sure you want to. How about I help you decide, kill a hostage?
Just do what they want! I beg you!
Calm yourself! No one is to be harmed, clear?
Nothing simpler. So long as you take your boys and pull out, we'll all live happily ever after.
I repeat, that is not an option. We must bargain, reach an agreement.
See if I can't make this clear. We're not at a food market. No bargains to be made here. Lives are at stake.
I understand. I do. But...
No buts. Gonna count to three, then heads will roll. One...
God have mercy! Just do what he asks!
You leave me no choice!
Two...
Attack!
Oops, tip the scales.
No to najwyraźniej zostaliśmy sami.
negotiator. Where's Eveline?
She's fled. All the better. Fewer hands reaching out for loot. Come on before reinforcements arrive.
Lock, lovingly crafted. Two spring-loaded bolts, cylindrical plugs, damaritian wards.
I'm not interested. No one's interested. We go in. Geralt, you're at the fore.
Why me?
It's why I hired you. Now move. We've no time.
No, nagle mamy wszystkie nasze miecze.
That's it for now. Same paintings were on the block.
They're in the vault! Lock themselves in!
Look for the spare key!
Vididia!
You don't know who you're fucking with!
On the contrary, I know all too well.
Yuld?
Greetings, brother. Been years.
Well, well. Complications, complications.
Should have known. Same eyes, same double chin, same rotten heart. Just one question. This family reunion? What's the point?
Revenge. For betrayal. Years of poverty. Humiliation. Father left the auction house to me in his will. Horst cheated me. Had me disinherited.
Anything. Everything we earned, you squandered on cards and whores. Father didn't see that. I did.
That's no excuse, Horst. And it won't save your life.
You two, stand with me. I'll not let the Redanians lay a hand on you. Give you whatever you want.
Not about to meddle, especially not in family matters.
Then you'd have done better not to break into my vault. I fear it's too late to turn neutral. Stand with me, and I shall drape you in gold. Stand against me, and you'll remain here forever.
No i teraz ciekawe, co by tu wybrać.
That's your attitude. I'll stand with Yuld.
Speak for yourself. Tempting offer. I've succumbed.
You'll pay for that, Quinto. With your head. At them!
Stay in formation!
prefer to resolve this elsewise. Stolen the scrolls, thrown you out into the street. Revenge is best served cold, after all. But I don't mind serving it hot. No.
I beg you, mercy, for your brother. I shall do anything you ask.
Truly. Anything.
Anything.
Sign over to me all that you own. Then walk out as you stand, with just the clothing on your back.
Allow me one thing, any one thing.
Ah. 15 years. In the sewers. Begging. Like a beast. And you've the cheek to plead.
Satisfied?
Exceptionally. You?
No, and I won't be until I find Max Bersodi's house. In this vault, or so you said.
And it is. There. But I fear it's not yours for the taking. You see, it houses my father's will. A scroll, thanks to which Ewald Bersodi, long missing, will assume.
And Geralt of Rivia, who you cheated, what'll he assume?
Alas, but he's free to choose anything else.
You tricked me.
And you were prepared to let me face Horst's thugs alone. To my mind, we're even. Now, Max Borsoni's house, if you've absolutely got to have it, you'll need to take it from me by force.
Nie musiało się to tak kończyć.
Your way. Let's make this quick before the soldiers get down here.
As I said, at your service, mate.
That's enough of that. Candles. The Danians will be here soon. Damn it, secret passage. Where is it? Air seeping through the cracks. Passage must be here. Now, how do I open it?
Pewnie jak zwykle otwiera się ruszając jakąś książkę lub świecznik. Yes.
Nick of time. Now to get out of here.
Przepatrzmy jeszcze na szybko, co udało nam się zawinąć z domu.
Much for a herring. Crown a
thing. Need to chat.
I'm all ears, Witcher.
Got something for you.
I love gifts, but I prefer to unwrap them in private. All right, lads, mind the barrels. Going out for a jabber with Geralt. Come. What do you have for me?
Max Persody's house, as requested.
Ah, Horst must be livid.
He's not.
No?
He's not anything except dead. His brother, same thing. A few others, too.
Stones you've got. But I didn't think you'd have the stomach for a massacre.
Situation got out of hand.
Oh, sounds familiar. There you are, drinking, puffing on henbane, and then, surprise, heads rolling across the floor. And none know how or why.
I'm not amused.
No? Why not?
Because unlike you, Killing gives me no pleasure.
The boss orders aren't worth your tears. Sons of bitches to a man.
The Borsodis, what's your gripe? Get kicked out of an auction?
Worse, they evicted me from a home. Are you really interested?
Wouldn't have asked if I wasn't.
Ha! Cheeky as ever. My family, they took on some debt. A poor investment in a sawmill. A bad crop 1 year. A lawsuit lost. You know how it is. When it rains, it pours. We needed but a few weeks to recover. But Horst Borsodi had acquired our debt. All of it. Demanded it be repaid immediately. I pleaded. I begged. I tore open my shirt at his threshold. Ugh. It was like talking to a wall. I went to the auction. Saw those perfumed pricks by my father's sword. My mother's death mask. My brother's horse tack. Ah, Horst earned a pretty pile selling our mementos.
No surprise the animosity you feel for him.
That was but the start. My Iris's parents learned of my family's misfortune. And our betrothal was no more. They found her another suitor. One from beyond the sea. The anger I felt. I thought I'd gone mad. Went to the tavern, drank a round, a second, abroad, then had another tankard. And then, I asked the wrong bloke for help.
What happened then?
What happened then, Witcher, was one big stinking pile of shite. Well, why do you stand there? Do you need something still?
Third wish. Time you stated it.
A moment, Geralt. I must see to something. Then we'll chat. You there. Yank the herring out the barrel.
None of this dallying.
Now, ready to listen? Or do you still not give two shites about what I've got to say?
I'm ready. I'm listening.
Good. You'll return to your lord and tell him as follows. His demand was brazen. Hurt me to the core. For I was brought up to respect the sacred law of hospitality. And I shall not bend to an uncouth boor's dictum. Understood? I will pay him a visit shortly to test his willingness to adapt. So you ride off and announce me. And don't spare your horse. Got it?
Aye, got it.
Give this man a mount and leave him go. Come, Witcher. We must talk outside. The Aethiri believe one should only discuss important matters out of doors, with the gods as witnesses.
Fulfilled two of your wishes. Time I learned the third.
Confident, aren't you? Proud, sure of your strengths. Fearless.
Third task, if you don't mind.
Mutations. They stripped you of emotion. Tell me, have you ever loved? I mean, truly loved?
Yeah, I've loved. Can we get to the matter at hand?
Perhaps instead we ought to sit down inside. Have a good chat over some fiery water.
We'll drink once the job's done.
Afraid that's impossible. Succeed, and that's the end of me. Fail, and you'll not be back.
Third wish. Still waiting to hear it.
Aye, aren't you stubborn? Fine. Listen well. I had a wife once. The day I saw her last, I gave her a rose. A violet one. Bring me that blue. Wouldn't mind reminding myself what it looks like.
When was that? How long's it been? Flowers wilted and turned to dust by now.
You wished to hear a wish. Now you have. Fulfill it. I ride now to visit this Dauntless, but one of my men will remain here. He'll know how to find me. That is, of course, should you succeed.
At least you could tell me where your wife is.
In my old manor, east of Martin Foy's farmstead. I'd wish you godspeed, but, well, you understand, I'm sure. Goodbye, Geralt.
Rusty and covered in creepers. Need another way in.
Kendrick! 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 You there?
Not so loud.
Bah! God, scared me off to...
Not so loud, I said. Fog's not natural. Could be something in there hiding. Foglets or air nymphs, for example. Don't want to attract them. Believe me.
Foglets? Oh, sweet mother, my little, why did I ever come here?
Good question. What are you doing here?
See, Kendrick and me, we thought man has been empty all these years, full of fine things going to rot.
So you're a thief.
Thief steal from the living? What's the harm taking from the dead? Kendrick went to open a door. I stood watch. Suddenly heard his lamp smash. And nothing. Quiet. Called out to him, but...
Ah!
was that? One of them foglets you spoke of?
No.
Phew. That's a stone off my...
I'll see what that was and look for your partner. You?
Ain't about to wait around. I'm out of here.
Pretty sprawling, this estate. How am I gonna find that rose in this fog? Water's ice cold. Mountain stream cold. Water's ice cold. Mountain stream cold. Rather worn. Used often. Wonder by who. A busted lamp. And the ground's trampled. Somebody dragged something this way. A body? Someone dragged a wounded man through here. From cleated boots, leading from the back of the garden. I'd scooch along, Kitty. This place. What's that? That. Digging. Graves, unmarked, laid out in rows, like garden beds.
Hey. Hear me?
Thief. Body's mutilated.
Who are you?
Widzieliście nogi tej kobiety?
Not bad.
the fuck was that? No eyes or nostrils, deformed organs. Damn thing had no right to be alive.
Well, philosophers do still debate what it means to be alive, exactly.
Normally I'd be shocked, but not after what I just saw. Who are you two?
Clearly not animals. Think of us as friends of the house.
You know the master of the house, the owner?
Olgierd von Everick. Yes, we know him, but he left. And his wife became mistress of the house.
Great. So, Lady von Everick home? Could you announce me, say she has a guest?
Why do you wish to see her?
I'm here to get the violet rose Olgierd gave Iris just before he left.
Iris is inside, in the bedchamber upstairs. Take his key. It opens the rear door.
Guess I'll make my own introductions. So, how should I address you?
As you did now. We'd rather keep our names to ourselves.
Bardzo ciekawe, aż zobaczmy. Strasznie brzydko wygląda ta łopata. Na szczęście mam coś lepszego.
Careful. What the hell was that?
Gra nabiera klimatu.
Damage. Interesting.
jak ma wyglądać walka, to ja dziękuję. W nieskończoność będziemy się...
Chamber. Iris was supposed to be here. Gotta be her. Damn it.
You wish to see her? Here she is.
A man should frame his wishes carefully. It forestalls disappointment.
This some sick joke. Why didn't you tell me she was dead right away?
You didn't ask.
And why hasn't anyone buried her?
We can't. As for the caretaker, the one you cut down, while still alive, she ordered him to stay away from her for all time.
Her ghost's restless, angry, attacks intruders. Know why?
Lady Von Everick has endured much hardship. She's unaccustomed to guests and not fond of strange folk.
She can't hear us.
Seems I gotta speak to Iris's ghost.
It's no easy task to contact the mistress. Rage and bitterness fill her.
Got my ways. To make contact with Iris, I gotta bury her body. But that caretaker's macabre little cemetery won't do. Too much blood, too much fear.
She spent much time in the front garden.
Maybe there.
Wait. Take this key. It opens the front door.
Good dog. Tidy. And everything's clean, ready for a meal to be served. Caretaker must still set the table.
you like to sit here, but this is not a good place for a grave.
Too close to the house.
I'll keep searching. A grave here?
Iris von Everek adored flowers.
But she would never want to destroy them.
All right. I'll dig the grave somewhere else. This place seems suitable.
Yes, she loved to paint.
Did Iris von Everek have any last requests? Say how she wanted her remains disposed of?
She feared death. Worried none would see to her burial or say a kind word in parting.
Guess I'll be the one to do that. I didn't know Iris von Everek, but the paintings here show amply that she and Olgierd were a loving couple. Iris must have been happy, once. At times, fate muddles our path, and life turns toilsome, hard to bear. Yet all deserve respite and peace in death. The remains are interred. Let's summon her. Tormented spirit, I've laid your bones to rest. Forget your wrath, forget your grief. Show yourself. Forgive me for tearing you from your realm. I need to ask you. Should I follow you? All right. What is this place?
The painted world. The work of Iris von Everek.
How'd you two get in here?
We exist in both worlds at once.
All right. This is lovely and all, but where's Iris?
You awoke her but for a moment. If you wish to speak to her, you must tear her from her slumber completely.
Sure, but how?
You're a tracker, right? Saw you examining the tracks outside.
Yeah, so?
This is a world built of memories blurred and wilting. Moments our mistress wishes to forget, but cannot.
You need to find them, restore them, summon the fears that torment Iris, and destroy them.
Easy to say.
Thank you.
his wife. Look frozen mid-motion.
One of her memories.
It is blurred, incomplete. You must restore it.
Tattered decorations for a special occasion. Wine cup, just like the one Olgierd's holding. A wedding veil? Perfect match.
Your health, my dear wife.
And yours, my husband.
In my land, custom calls that newlyweds be greeted with bread and salt. But we're alone for now.
I need none but you. Oh, if only this moment could last forever.
I shall see what I can do. But come in and see our home.
Gladly, but I know this sounds silly, yet the house has sat empty for so long and I'm...
Afraid of spiders. I know. I swept them all up and tossed them in the garden.
My knight, you've seen to everything.
Medallion's humming. A wraith?
No. A nightmare.
A fear crystallized. One you must now face.
Another dream of the past, but this one's incomplete too.
Lavish feast, silver thread, impress the guests.
It all must have cost a fortune. Painting, a Toussaint wine. Expensive. Olgierd's wife liked flowers. Judging by the ornamentation, this might be hers. These were lit in the painting, but that's not all. Fire was burning in the painting. Still something missing, though.
My darling, is everything all right? You seem pale, out of sorts.
Everything's fine, really. But why don't you tell me how you fare? I'm ever so happy to see you. Except, why didn't Grandmama and Grandpapa come?
It's a long, rugged journey. Muddy.
They still refuse to meet me. Is that it? And what's this?
We've brought some of Iris's things. Her favorite brush, her cherished doll. This for you.
Banknotes.
We paid off your debts, bought them out, to avoid bringing shame to the family.
So nice of Mama and Papa to remember me.
Olgierd? Now you see his true nature? I warned you before the wedding. A ruffian and a boor who keeps the company of bandits. Are you not afraid to live under one roof with that rabble?
So let's follow him. Not you again. Don't like this place. The bedchamber. Towel stained with blood. Blood stains. Someone washed their hands, then wiped them dry on that towel.
What time is it?
It's late. Sleep.
Up all night in your study again, I see. What have you got on your hands?
Nothing. Got a bit dirty, that's it.
Is that blood? Have you hurt yourself?
Ink stains. I was writing letters. I shall go to Oxenfurt soon. Perhaps you'd come with me.
Oh, that's a marvelous idea. A trip would do us both so much good.
Then it's decided. Now, time for bed. I'm exhausted.
I shan't fall asleep now. It's out of the question. Come, I shall finish your portrait.
Another blurred memory. She painted Olgierd, but the details are off. Living tableau's missing something. Goblet, like the one in the painting. Fresh, as if someone just rinsed it. Living tableau's gotta look just like the painting. Still not right. Living tableau's gotta look just like the painting. This goes here. Fits, I think. Still not right. tableau's gotta look just like the painting. Maybe on this side. Finally, just like the picture.
Smile a bit wider.
Like this?
You were meant to smile, not bare your teeth. No, still wrong. Smile like you did when Papa agreed we could marry. Please? You're useless. I can tell something's bothering you.
I've a bit of work I should see to.
Again? Olgierd, we agreed not to keep any secrets from one another. We promised.
Forgive me. I don't wish to discuss this.
Olgierd. Olgierd!
Master von Everick's study. Here he immersed himself in the arcane arts.
Pentagrams here to bind summoned beings. Lines aren't all clear though.
Blood pacts.
Chalk to fix them.
On foreign presences.
Beeswax candles. The gates of mystery. Between worlds. The library of an occultist. For some kind of magic, I bet. Chalk. Manor was depressingly gloomy in the winter. Black magic. That should do it. Now for the candles. Let's try this. Nothing. What about this? Not even a fizzle. How about this?
Come back! We must talk!
Go away. I wish to be alone.
Not this time. Come out at once!
Leave me be. I merely want to work in peace. What other spell must I use, damn it? I've tried them all. I wish to end our pact. I summon it!
Expect that.
Boris and Olgierd. So this is when he started smoking. A beer tankard, but there was vodka in it. Drained to the last drop. Probably not right. So that's how he whiled away the long winter evenings. Her father must have been holding the contract.
Furthermore, it is agreed that Iris shall be accorded the respect she is owed, that you shall heed her counsel and requests, and...
Get to the point, Father. My patience runs thin.
Gladly. On Iris's request, I declare this marriage null and void.
You vowed to remain with me till death do us part.
And I've held to my vow. The Olgierd I married is no more.
Breaking a word once given does not come that easy. Believe me, you shall stay here forever.
Enough! You will not command us. You will...
Servant, take this carcass and feed it to the beasts.
Then Von Everick ceased to be human.
Though he still loved his wife.
No, he merely remembered that he should love her.
Let's go upstairs.
I remember. We spent much time together here, the three of us.
In silence.
Animal.
We'll take our places, the same as then.
Single place.
You do the rest.
No others on the table. Claw scratches. Clay bowl. Small bowl. For soup, maybe? There we go. Probably not right. A platter. This was yours. Perfect match. Do you actually eat from these bowls?
Of course not. I already told you, we're not animals.
But the caretaker would set them out all the same, as ordered.
Another monstrosity. I begged you to stop this. Those two are too many as it is.
The dog and cat keep you company. This one will protect you, care for the house, no matter what happens.
Before, I wished to know what was going on in that head of yours. I thought perhaps I could help. Now, I care not the slightest what you think or how you feel.
I feel nothing.
Just as I no longer know if I still hate you. Go, Olgierd. I want you out of my sight.
Olgierd von Everick failed to understand we'd never be able to replace him.
His specter now casts a shadow over Lady Iris's every remembrance. We're almost at our journey's end.
What's there?
Iris von Everick's greatest fear.
dearest wife. Letters from Olgierd to Iris. Were I only as skilled with words as I am with my blade. Especially now, when an icy void grips my heart. I see how you look at me, and I see you wither. I cannot help you, but I believe I can cease harming you. This letter and this rose are my farewell. May you live in health, and remember but the good times, Olgierd.
You're not him.
Wait, I want to talk.
Not here. Not in this place. I'm sorry. I mistook you for another.
For Olgierd?
I thought he'd returned to me.
What are you? A ghost? An illusion?
sadness.
I've come for the violet rose Olgir gave you.
On the day we saw one another for the last time, I dried it and placed it in our chamber, at my bedside. I lay there for days, staring at it, until at last it crumbled into dust, as did I soon after.
So, the rose is gone?
Not from this world. Look, you buried my body and the flowers bloomed once more. And I was held in a deep, dark sleep. Only now have I awoken, just like my beautiful rose. Tell me, how is Olgird? Healthy? Does he fare well?
Your husband hunts out ever stronger sensations. He tempts fate, because at heart he's unhappy.
At heart he is stone, so nothing has changed. And did Olgird mention me? What did he say?
Not much, but I didn't ask about you. He just sent me to retrieve the rose.
The rose? The last I have left of him. His last gift.
The rose. Will you give it to me?
It's so fragile. Look, the petal edges have turned crimson, as they were on the day I received it. The one thing missing is the single drop of dew which slid down the leaf when I took the rose in hand. Or was it blood? Because I pricked my finger. I can't remember. You know, I never did read the letter from Olgird. I didn't have to. And I needn't have kept the flower he left me. I've come to a decision. I shall give you the rose.
Our service thus ends. Thank you, stranger, for freeing us.
Before we go, some advice. Beware of the one called the Man of Glass. Stand in his way, and you'll meet a fate worse than death. Seek salvation in glass that can't be broken.
Glass that can't be broken?
So long.
I'll remember you, Iris von Everek.
That no longer matters. Farewell.
W długiej przygodzie za wspomnieniami żony Olgierda Czas zakończyć ten odcinek w następnym odcinku. Nie bójcie się, nie ominie was szczegółowa opowieść z tego dodatku.